Welcome back to Letter Customs fans. So today we will be working on Mr. Melchior's B16 VTEC. Yes, we're making a change for once. We're actually working on a Honda and not on a Golf. So we will be doing a nice service on this car, and he'll just explain to you guys like a before and after of the difference actually of the service, like performance wise of his ride. And let's get straight into it. For this video you will be needing your oil, your antifreeze, your plugs and your oil filter. Note that with Hondas you will be needing an original oil filter. Please guys, you have to buy original oil filter. Well, there have been a few problems with guys running with like aftermarket like filters and not buying the original manufacturer's oil filter. But guys, like I said, it's always recommended to buy the original oil filter and the original parts of the car. But the rest of the parts were bought at Midas, but the antifreeze and the oil filter were bought at Honda itself, because like it plays like a small like role for your performance out of the car. But these this Shell Helix 10W40, well, that's an amazing oil. I even use it on my own car. So these are the parts you'll be using for your car for a minor service on a B-Series Honda. So let's get straight into the Honda. Engine bay door. Mr. Miyagi, you have to clean this bay though.
Hey.
Why is this bay so dirty, my friend?
This is a respray.
Is it the respray? Yes. So if you guys don't know this Honda, this Honda was previously Lukman's Honda. And owned by Melchior. Melchior now. Well, Melchior rescued this car, to be honest. He resprayed the car, he's done interiors, and he's done a few other small odds and ends. So, Mr. Impatient is back in the builders. And he actually rescued this car, so big thanks to Melly for rescuing this B-Series Honda.
That's a pleasure.
Melly, what's your future plans on this Honda?
For now, I'm probably just gonna get sleeve overs for the back, because that back is a lowering kit. So
you do have sleeves in front?
I have sleeves in front, yes. And I'm gonna do the back, and I was thinking of a Type R intake, and then just freshen up the bearings along the windows.
Is it? So you said you had sleeve overs in the car. In my previous video, I actually installed some sleeve overs. So what's your opinion? How does these sleeve overs drive in this car?
To be honest, if I had the choice to, how can I say, to go suspension, if I had to buy the first suspension kit, I would probably go coilovers, because sleeve overs isn't so advanced as what coilovers are, so yeah.
Yeah, because I mean, like I told many guys to actually buy coilovers, and they'd actually buy sleeve overs and they end up being unhappy. So are you unhappy, or is it still alright to go on with?
It's alright to drive with, yeah, but your quality is
not there.
Yeah.
Well guys, do you heard it? Well, this is the height of Melchior's Honda and sleeve overs in front. Melchior's is your lowest? It's not the lowest. The car can go lower, but note he did say that he does prefer going coilovers instead of sleeve overs. So guys, I would say do your coilovers one time on these B-Series Hondas. This is the EK shape. So one time do the coilovers and you will have the stability you want and you will have the lowness you would want. So let's jump straight into the video. We're gonna start off with draining the old oil out of the car. And but first step, let's check up this ride. Melchior is busy checking up the other side of the car. I just want to give his word to you guys that this car is for sale. This is a B16 VTEC new spec. Maroon, and the maroon is really scarce, you guys. You guys don't get it as often as the other new spec VTECs you see out there daily. And so I will put these details in the description below, and if you guys are or you guys would like to know any information about the car, his number and his details will be in the description below. I won't be mentioning anything on video because that's his personal word to you guys. Another thing I would like to mention is that safety first in your car, guys. So when checking up your car, just always put like a strengthening, what you call it, known as in Afrikaans a bokkie underneath your car. So just let your car rather rest on that, or if you have like a nice strong brick or like if you have a tripod, you guys just like let your car rest rather on the tripod and resting it on the jack, because the jack can collapse and that would mean some major injuries. So safety first, you guys. So let's start draining the oil of this car and removing the spark plug. We will be needing a 10mm socket to remove this cover off the valve cover. So let's get started. Now we'll have to remove these coil leads in order to get to the spark plugs. So remove them one by one, and also note when you're putting it back, you will have to put it back like number 1, 2 and 3, spark plug number 1, 2 and 3. Before we use that, I have to remove this side here now quick. The bracket just in the way quick. So just remove the bracket quick. Don't let the nuts fall into the holes, because that will be a really crap story. At the previous incident where actually like a rubber fell into it, and trust me, it took us a whole night to get that rubber out. So just keep your screws and your bolts and shit to one side. So just remove all the leads and then we can get to the spark plugs. Right, so to remove the spark plugs, you will be needing this tool, or you'll be needing a socket. I'm not sure what size this is, but you can buy this at the nearest Midas store, or Sandy Spears, or Stellenbosch Motor Spears. They sell these products, and as well, nowadays they sell a socket in the form of this. The socket is way easier, because then you can use your ratchet, and it gets like, you get way more grip on it. And note whenever you're tightening it up again, not to tighten it too tight. So let's just keep removing this. You guys can see there, the spark plug is kind of klaar. It has kilometers on it. And you can see the oil that's on it is not actually on the spark plug. So what happens is that these B-series motors, they have a seal right in this hole right here, so maybe it basically means that the seal isn't probably sealing, and that's the reason for the oil. So you don't have to worry about it whenever removing it. That could maybe basically be the reason why you top up your oil each time. So you probably just have to buy a new head gasket or a head gasket set with all the seals and the bolts and shit like that, and you can get that sorted as well. Cool, so let's just grab these new plugs and put it in this B-series motor. Just to do a small comparison on how spark plugs actually look. I am interrupting today's video just to show you guys the new stickers I made. Also, big shout out to Johnman and Mukit for actually designing my stickers for. Well, Mukit is originally from, I think, Joburg, Eastern Cape. He sent me the stickers, or the design of the stickers through my email, and I took it to Johnman to print it out. So guys, I'm thankful for both of you guys actually supporting me and making me the stickers. Also, just check out these designs. They are 30 rand each. I have a variety of colors. I have yellow, black, red, chrome, and white. So if you guys are interested in any of the stickers, you guys are more than willing to send me an Instagram. All my details are on Instagram, even my cell phone number, so you guys can give me a phone call or a WhatsApp if you guys are interested in these stickers. So just check out these stickers right here. Well, you guys saw the stickers I did. And the stickers design are amazing. They are like an Instagram icon and with the latest customs ID. The stickers for my crew. And yes, you guys heard it. I am creating my own crew. So if you guys are interested in joining the crew, the entry for the crew or the registration for the crew, for you in order to join the crew, you will have to buy one of my stickers, and that will be one of the big stickers for the back window. I know most of you guys are not really a fan of the big stickers, so you guys are more than willing to buy one of the smaller stickers for your back window. It's not a crew for hookups and shit like that, but it is a crew. So if you guys are willing to join the crew, if you guys like my stickers, please leave a comment down below. And please do follow Johnman as well as Mukit on Instagram. They are designers for the stickers and they are reliable. The quality are great. And I'm really thankful for you guys for actually supporting me and designing these stickers. So back to the normal program. Thank you. this is the old one, you guys can see right there. And this is the new one. You can see how fresh it actually looks. And if you ever actually have like a measurement for these spark plugs, you can actually see how it's like less than a millimeter could make a big difference on your motor's performance. So I'll say on these high performance motors, change your spark plugs every 10k and change your oil every 5k kilometers wise now. And if you do drive hard like every single day, change your spark plugs as well as every 5k and your oil every 5k. Or like you can do your oil also in you can do your oil service intervals anytime you would like, just before 5k, and that will keep your motor's performance like really high. I don't know if you guys can see here, we're using the BKR6E N11 or what's that, double L spark plug for these Hondas. You can buy this at your nearest Midas store. Like I said, all the stuff we bought there, we bought at the nearest Midas store. But the original Honda parts, you obviously have to buy the Honda. So we use the spark plugs for the Honda, and these perform great on these Hondas. So go with these. Don't go with the cheap ones. The cheap ones make your car crap and make your car slow. Whenever putting in the spark plugs, always be careful, because if you spoil the thread on your block, trust me, or basically on your head, it's going to be a major setback for you, and especially in your pocket. Cool. So when even tightening spark plugs, you don't need to tighten your spark plugs too tight, because you just don't need to. So just give it a nice grip, and when you feel it, it's nice stiff. Just check out the amount of force, or basically reverse force I actually apply on this. You guys can actually see like how tight they actually like turn up. And there you go, that's actually enough. So we just fitted all the spark plugs, so just remember when reassembling the leads, put each one on its own like hole which it came out from. So like it's usually how it works is that the shortest usually goes in first. So you guys can see this one is the shortest right here. So this one actually goes in first. Then you have this one right here. Then you have this one right here. And you have the last one. So just double check that they're all actually really tight in, because spark plugs are a very important role in your engine's performance. And just assemble whatever you took off in the process. Difficult to film what I'm actually going to do right now, because the oil filter is at the back of the block. So I'll be using the heating like a hole in it and trying to turn it with the screwdriver. You have to turn it like a hole each time and like turn it like very slightly. So I'm going to try this method, because I don't have the proper tool to remove the oil filter on the car, and it's very slippery and very tight, so I can't get like big grip on it. And the car is very low, and the jack doesn't lift the car up that high in order for me to get that much grip on it to actually turn it. So I'm actually going to use the hammer method, and we're going to see if we can actually get this oil filter off this car. Because the sump is still dripping, and it's like only like dripping very, very slowly, so I thought one day I'm going to put the sump plug back in. So note, it's very important to put the new washer. The new washer will usually come in the oil filter by Honda, or you have to buy it separately. So please remember to buy the washer, because the washer prevents any leakages from the oil sump. So put the washer on the sump plug, and we can just turn it back in.
Just to put on top of what Sain said about the sump, just make sure that when you put the sump plug back with your 17mm that you do tighten it properly, because you would not want your sump plug to fall out while you're driving. That can have major issues, which you would be so sorry for later. Also note, while you're removing the oil filter, just to move the can that you used for the oil to drip out of the sump, to move that under the oil filter, because where the oil do drip from the oil filter too.
So whenever replacing the oil filter, just note the surface right here, this is rubber. So you've been hearing what I always do, I take off the oil and just rub around it, just to get that nice texture on there, and it to get it to properly seal up, because sealing is the main goal right here. And you don't want even your oil filter to be leaking as well. Note, whenever replacing this as well, to always clean up the surface which this turns on, or which the old one came from. Cleaning up the surface will prevent any leakages and anything like that. And it always keeps it right clean in the back of your block. In the back of your mind, you know it's clean, so yeah, always stay clean. So note, whenever tightening the oil filter, just the hand tighten, don't tighten it too tight. Don't tighten it with any like water tongue or anything like that. Just tighten it with the hand, and for the next person to get off, but also not for it to actually leak. So just hand tighten it. What I forgot to mention is that when I replaced the oil filter, the old one actually came off by hand. So I used my George Power, and I actually removed the oil filter. So now you just have to grab, see the pliers, it's not pliers, but I'm going to use the spatula just to remove the bracket off of the radiator to drain all the water out of the radiator. And to drain all the water, we'll be draining, we'll be removing this pipe right here, this rubber tube. This rubber tube is at the bottom of the radiator, and it makes it easier to drain out all the water. So when you remove the top one, it's going to make no use, because there's nothing on top, everything is at the bottom, because if you remove this bottom one, all the water will actually flow out. So we're going to remove the bottom one, and the reason why I'm using actually this like above pliers and anything like that is because it actually locks up really well, and the bracket doesn't get loose or anything like that, so it's easier. So now the time comes where you can actually lower the car. Just note, whenever you're throwing back in the new oil, make sure the car is on a level surface, because whenever you're pulling out the dipstick to check out the oil, the car has to be level, because everything has to be level, then you can check the oil, you can get the right oil reading on the car. Keep your spark plugs, doesn't matter how bad they are. There are ways on YouTube how to, it's not safe a spark plug, but how to reuse a spark plug for years. So maybe you can check out one of those videos. But in my opinion, just fuck them away. Fucking thing, that's an opener, yo. Nice opener, bro, relax, so we're gonna open, bro. So we're gonna start off with the antifreeze first. So E44 in, which I'm not gonna do. I'm probably going to miss some out. What I'm going to do I'm only going to fill in one antifreeze now, a bottle of antifreeze for now, because I mean, she's actually laying here in the top, because there is still some water circulating in the system, and I'm just going to top up the oil. I think we like use like a little bit more than 4 liters of oil for this motor, and we're also going to get this car started, and while the car is idling, then after the throwing in the oil, I'll just top up the antifreeze as well. When the antifreeze both bottles is up, you can actually throw these bottles with water again and actually like shake it a little bit and just throw it in as well, because every little bit helps. Time for them oil though. But also, don't you want to use your teeth for this?
Eva.
Give me a flat iron. I'm probably going to miss now. Also, we're just going to double check on Yalsho's oil reading at the moment, because I didn't throw too much oil in. So we're just going to double check his oil reading. This is wait like for 2 or 3 seconds, and then you just pull out the lipstick. I don't know if you guys can see there, but I mean, like this oil here on top doesn't matter, but I mean, like, to the point there is where it's important. The second hole right there, that's where all this oil is supposed to be. So, what we're gonna do now, we're just gonna idle this car for the oil to circulate in this oil filter at the moment, and then for his antifreeze just to like down a little bit, and then we can top up everything in the car. So we're just going to do a chicken oil check on the car. Just see where the oil is off the item. You guys can see that the low the oil is actually laying at the moment, just because of all the oil that went into the oil filter. But let's just double check. So we're going to do a third check of oil after pouring in some more oil. So a third oil check, you guys can see right there, it's basically almost on its mark, but let's just double check. And the oil level is basically perfect, so yeah. Me and Melcio are actually done service in the car at the moment. We did let the car run a while, and I'm letting the car cool down just to double check the oil, and it basically used almost the entire 5 liter of oil. So I guess these cars actually use a little bit more, or basically more than 4.5 liters of oil. I'm not sure if the Honda guys, you guys can please update me on this. I was a Honda owner, but I think mine also took a little bit more than 4.5 liters of oil. So after this, we're just going to double check that this car's fan goes on 3 times at least, and this car doesn't overheat anything like that, and there's no oil drips and shit like that, then Melcio will be safe to go home. I'm going to do a very short cinematics of his car, and you guys can make your prices. He already has a price in mind, and you guys can just like flow into his DMs with the office, and you guys can take the negotiations from there. But this is a very beautiful car. Very scarce as well, in this color specifically. At the moment we're still waiting for Melcio's car to heat up properly all the way, and the fan didn't even go once yet, so we're still waiting on that. And his heat temperature is still laying on the same place, so I think that the antifreeze is actually kicking in at the moment. Once again guys, thanks to all of you guys for your support. Note, I did hit 3000 subscribers, and I thank you guys. I couldn't do it without you guys. So please make that 4000, 5000, 6000, I mean like, just let the rankings go up and shit like that, because I'm thankful for actually reaching this point of my channel. I didn't think I would be able to actually reach 3000 this quick, so I wouldn't be able to do it without you guys. And please do, for all of you guys that didn't subscribe yet or didn't hit that click the bell yet, please do so now, because each and every one subscriber helps, and each like do help as well. So do like this video as well. Do share this video, do spread this video to your friends. And for all the B-Series lovers out there and all the Honda lovers out there, this video is for you guys. Shot guys and enjoy your day.